And suddenly, the Word was flesh, incarnate, human, breakable, common. Morning light into darkness, and that life light blazed out of the darkness, and the darkness could not put it out. Redeemer, Savior, Messiah, Lord, His name, Jesus. He became human, and He lived among us. We saw His glory, the glory that belongs only to the Son of the Father, and He was full of grace and truth. Now awake, O sleeper, arise from the dead, the Messiah will shine on you. This baby in a manger, this Word made flesh, His light will make all things visible. This is the story of the birth of the Prince of Peace.
Joy.
It was during the reign of the Roman Emperor Caesar Augustus, great nephew of Julius Caesar, that a baby was born in Israel. At that time, Caesar decreed a census, and an edict was issued requiring all people to register in the city of their ancestors. It was this census that caused a young couple, Joseph from the royal line of King David, and Mary, great with child, to undertake a journey of some days from the north country of Nazareth to the city of David. When they reached Bethlehem, they found shelter in a stable because there was no other room. And so it was, in the most common of circumstances, that a most uncommon baby was born. They named him Jesus. Now, this was a night for journey, because in a nearby field, a fearsome angel of the Lord, joined by a mighty host of angels, announced to shepherds the birth of the baby, the Savior. This is how you will know him. You will find him wrapped in pieces of cloth, lying in a manger. Thus, this story of journeys, begun with Caesar, the most powerful man on earth, continues with Mary and Joseph, the angels, and the shepherds. But God was not finished. Glory to God in the highest. And on earth, peace.
Creation stands in awe. Good luck, creep days, and now we know.
vividly and instinctively know that something otherworldly is occurring. Kings from far-off lands witness an astonishing sight in the heavens. Shepherds are awakened by the sound from a sound sleep and actually come face to face with the magnificent miraculous. The world is waiting in solemn stillness, all creation ready to burst with praise. And now, the Prince of Peace has finally come. The song of the angels is carried on the gentle winds of the evening. Listen, be very still and listen. There, off in the distance, the good news of peace on earth. Do you hear what I hear?
Kings seeking to be king, and yes, another journey.
stood detected something new in the heavens. They soon realized they were witness to a miracle. And when they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy and began to sojourn in the city of David, and an audience with the Holy Child. From the dawning of creation, peace was always the Father's plan. But Eden's garden of protection was defiled by sinful man. Cruel death and separation, the deceiver's awful creed. He consumed those meant for living, destroyed alone who we grieve. Then God bends down in mercy, reveals his endless grace, to pay the price of justice, sends his Son to take our place. He came in humble fashion, to earthly man unknown, this baby in a manger, the heir to heaven's throne. Oh, the night of his appearing marked the dawn of our release, highest glory in the heavens and on earth. Peace.
Show. Thank you.
Lord Jesus, thank you for the gift of peace. Help us to see the world through your eyes. Listen to those in need through your ears. We ask you to give us the protection of heaven and on earth. Peace. Now, may the Lord of peace himself grant you his peace, the peace of his kingdom, at all times and in all ways, under all circumstances and conditions, whatever comes. The Lord be with you all.